Yeah, man, you all continue doing the thing, you know? As I say, family, friends, and community. And we're going to continue in that same vein. Not necessarily in that order, but we're going to continue with it just the same. We're not going to include no politics and no religion, so to speak. We'll make a little reference here and there, but no major discussion, no major reference to politics or religion. Yes. Oswald George Cunningham was my first bona fide brethren. 19 French Avenue, Media 6. And as I tell you before, it's usually your mother friend how you become friends with their children. Yes. And I have vivid memories as a youth, maybe 4 or 5 years old. The Cunninghams used to have a rocking chair. They used to have a set of chairs on them veranda, painted red and white, made out of wood. But they had a rocking chair. And me and Ozzy would have rocked that chair from one end of the veranda to the next, you know. Sometimes we rock it down the stairs. The little walkway to come up into the living room. And the amount of beating when me and him get for that, you know. Because it's a chippy hour, we say we're going to mash up that chair, we're going to mash up that chair. We never mash up the chair still, but we should just rock the chair like a one as it upon the right, me upon the left, or vice versa. We just ride it like a horse, because I saw that a furry little horse. One upon one side of the rocking chair, one upon the other side, and we just rock the chair and rock the chair. Yeah, man. I mean, as we go to infant school, we go to primary school, and then after we leave primary school now, as I go to senior school, Bombrook Secondary, so to speak, and I went to Titchfield. After third form, as I come back at Titchfield, but we never lose, and like I said, we lose contact, you know, but we start develop different friends and different connections, but we still live in a central. Yeah, man, at which point in time, we have very little athletic talent. So me could have run, as I could have played football and cricket, and with time, we start a little team named Real Antonio. Yeah, man. All the man them from Central. And we call upon Mr. Canicle, call him manager. That time he used to manage Del Mar Theatre. Yeah, to be our manager and coach, so to speak. Because I don't really have no sophisticated knowledge about football, but you know, every man an expert. So anyway, we form Real Antonio. So if I talk about the connection with the community and the little talent that we have in the community, because trust me, you know, we don't talk about musical talent, we don't talk about athletic talent. You have a youth named T.T. Cunningham. I don't know if there's any other youth in a rural Jamaica at that time was talented as him, you know, who could have mastered the art of cricket and soccer, football. But you see, talent at them time there, you have to also match that with opportunity. And a lot of the youths in the community never really have the opportunity to move ahead. For whatever reason, you know. But I remember, as I went reference to church now, Miss Eva and my mother, Lynette, used to go to Methodist Church. So Methodist Church now used to have communion maybe once a month. And my mother used to go into the vestry. Time to take me think about it, I have to just laugh. My mother used to go into the vestry right behind the church. Got prepared for the communion. But Methodist Church them time there, unlike the Catholic Church who used to bring in for them wine and wafer straight from the Vatican. Methodist Church them time they used to just get stale bread from Carnation Bakery and cut it up into some little cube. And a Welch's grape juice they used to use for them wine. So one Sunday now, you know, my husband said, alright, here what go happen now, because enough time they make whole heap of the little small glass of wine and whole heap of the wafer, but whenever wafer, like a cut up bread, stale bread, kind of hardened. And he used to come back into the vestry if enough people don't come to take communion. So one Sunday, my husband, you know, do nothing but drink half the whole of the grape juice and come back and the whole of the wine. Because usually, them pour back what they use in the bottle for use for next time, put in the fridge and use the next time. And my husband drink half the whole of the amount of beating where we get, you know. We'll never forget it, it was just like yesterday. Yeah. And with time, you know, friendship moved to other youths in the neighborhood. So we are talking about man from Bunbrook, man from Prospect, man from Central, Summerstone, all about. Yeah. And we kind of just maintain our friendships at different levels, depending on where you participate. Because me was a man who used to participate in all kind of things at school, all kind of things. Whether table tennis, whether money football, whether cricket, whether soccer, whether swimming with Mr. Fullstar up at Winifred Beach. You'd have a little Indian man named Willie. And Willie used to drive the little blue Ford Transit van. And I tell you, man, and all of we pack up and go to Winifred Beach for swim. And we could have easily swim down at the Tree Beach, you know, but through the tide, we used to just wash in the stone them all the time. The beach wasn't really in a good swimming condition. Yeah. But as youths, we grew up in the community in such a way that we never really care about who your mother was or who your father was or anything like that. We just know every man a friend and company. And we have a little group of friend and company who we do all kind of things. But we know the limitations still. We know say one man is a big time football player, you know, one man is a good musician. And talking about musician, remember them have like a band named Sing Out Port Antonio. With the man them from on a bar fall. Now, me ask a man a question. Them have three places in a Port Antonio. Janga Gully, Breastwork, and Bar Fall. And where them names they come from? Bar Fall. Anybody can spell that? Remember, you used to have a little place run away. But if you can't swim, you know, really want to go around there, you know. Yeah, I mean, I have a friend named Chappie. Used to live around there. Yes, Chappie. Remember him well. But anyway, the way our community set up was Carter Park was a central location for any kind of sporting activity. But they have some man from Upper Prospect, they have some football team there. I tell you, man, when them man meet against all Bunbrook, you know, at Bunbrook they are the west and Prospect they up at the east. So when time Carter Park meet up to play football, oh, you can't find space for walk, can't find a battle with a car, play sell off. I tell you, man, nice. So our community was rich in many, many ways. So when I had a church thing from around Mr. Pier Church, and talk about Mr. Pier Church around a seaside road. I remember two men used to come around there once a year from the Bahamas. Burroughs and Cash used to pitch tent around them and go and collect some serious thing around them, and enough knives and enough things go on. Mr. Rose Church around Manning's Avenue. I remember sitting out of Mr. Rose Church, the one down at Bunbrook Road there. Beeson, out of them things that the man are developing and now, them man they are big timer. You know the Pentecostal thing, you know the religion thing of Jamaica. Straight like out of our little town there, Port Antonio. So I talk about from business people to musician to athlete of every level. Rosie Harwood, Regina Montague, Carl Anderson, Upton and Norman Allen, Woo Leaper man, Kingsley Chin. Yeah, man, Teddy Taylor, and now we see Diva Argyll, right out of Port Antonio there. So our little town was coming like a microcosm of what Jamaica represented to the world in many, many levels. I remember the woman them from down at Port Antonio as businesswoman. I mean, a photographer woman named Miss Wolf. If a lady named Miss Salah used to go to town every morning for Gleena, you know. She was the first minibus driver. If you want to go to town early, you catch Miss Salah bus go to town. Because she used to go to town every morning and come back with the Gleena. And Star used to come on a little mail bus later on that evening. And talk about bus and transportation. Port Antonio, I tell you, from big bus, mail bus, Mr. Hall bus, Victor bus. Then they have a fancy bus named Tommy. When Tommy come through town, Tommy had first bus Mr. with curtain in a Port Antonio, you know. But anyway, our little town was so rich, and there are so many stories to be told. From all the halls of power to all the people who you think are just ordinary people. And very few and very little criminality. I just remember as a youth, we used to walk past the station and you could look right back and switch back to the jailhouse, and all you can hear a man run, so, Paul, Perry, Paca, call my mother for me now because boy, I'm want some bail and soup now deal with me right. But you kind of have to keep your head straight because you don't really want nobody to know, so you know them man around the back. But you know them, you know how. Capote is a small place. But our little town is just rich at many levels, man. In the next series, I'm going to touch on some other little stories coming out of our little town that You'd be surprised to understand how things like dance. Remember, a man named Never Black came into Port Antonio and recruited some dancers. Mikey Dread was one of them. Russis Tony was one of them. Carol Murdoch, who went on to dance with NDTC for many, many years, developed straight out of Port Antonio there. You know, musicians of the highest order, poets, dancers, artists, our little town there, representative man, very, very, very at the highest level. Yes. So I will continue the series, and as I move forward, I want to just stay tuned, because I like you to understand that this is just part of the storytelling, so we can remind ourselves that while we might live in, you know, big cities now, and we, you know, we are enjoying a decent life, when you come back to the little town, you know, I hear nobody and say, boy, oh, the town so hot. It is hot from morning. As a matter of fact, Port Antonio cooler than in the 70s and the 80s. Because I come America now and come to England and I'm used to the air condition. Never used to no air condition or hot water. You know what I mean? Just remember your roots, the fundamentals of your life is your roots and your culture. And if you can give back as much as you possibly can. Alright? So as I leave you, a church lady from Marrington Avenue last week passed through Fort Lauderdale. But we know her from Marrington Avenue. So one of my friends looked upon her and said, Miss May, you know if any churches around here giving the COVID test? Miss May said, no, sir. A papa is me eating, you know. So with that, I said, walk good and take care of yourselves. Alright? Remember, giving back starts with giving. All right.